Yeah, my life now is all about giving back. And if we can do that in some way, you know, make the world a better place in some way, even if it's some small way, well, then today was worth living, you know? A genocide occurred in Rwanda several years ago, where over 1 million people were slaughtered in just a few weeks. Now, what that left was a tremendous amount of widows and orphans that had no skills to be able to earn money to buy food. Now, they'll find a way somehow or another. They have to survive, but it may not be always the best way to do it. So I teamed up with an organization that wanted to build a school over there to teach basic skills, skills like sewing, like carpentry, like welding, so they could go out and earn an honest living and provide for themselves and their family. And I was able to go over there and meet these students and hear what they had to say about how their lives have changed as a result of this school. And it was just absolutely overwhelming, the difference that it's making in a lot of people's lives. Every 6 seconds, a child dies of malnourishment somewhere in the world. And Malawi, Africa was one of the worst. Well, I started working with a group whose goal was to build an agricultural school over there to teach these people how to farm the land that they do have. So not just to give them a fish, but teach them how to fish, so to speak. And it's fantastic because we pay for them to, the families from different villages, to be there for an entire year, an entire growing season. And we pay for their food and their shelter and their seed and their farming implements for that entire year. And then their job is to go back to their villages that next year and teach the village how to do those techniques. Nice. And we follow up with them for an entire year doing that. And I got to go out there to Malawi and go to some of the remote villages that have been touched by this program. And as I went to one village, I guess they heard I was coming. And as I approached their building that they had, all of a sudden their village was in there and they erupted into their welcome song. And it was absolutely amazing that these people that had absolutely nothing to give gave me probably the best gift I've ever had as their voices came together in this beautiful music. And I was just absolutely overwhelmed and didn't really know what to do. And then we heard from the Malawi government not long ago that for the entire year, not a single person has died of malnourishment in the entire country. Everybody can make a difference. Well, you know, the city that I grew up in is literally the poorest city in the United States of America. And I wanted to give back to that city because that is my hometown. And I wanted to give back especially to those kids who had the desire to go to college and had the grades to go to college, but had no way to afford being able to go to college. So I wanted to start up the scholarship for underprivileged youth right there in my old high school. And it's been fantastic seeing the good that has done. Now, I absolutely love being a scoutmaster because we get to take these boys away from their video games and away from their television sets and every bad influence that comes into them and pull them out of there and get them out of the outdoors, get them out into the woods, get them doing fun things, using their imagination and teaching them that it's okay to be trustworthy and loyal and helpful and friendly and courteous and all of those things. In fact, it's not only okay, it's expected of them. And we use the program and the adventures that we go on and everything for one main goal, and that's to teach them to be honorable men. Helping give back. And JFK once said that one man can make a difference and that every man should try. And I think that's absolutely true. To me, it's about being able to go to bed every night and knowing that the world is a better place because you were in it today. Now imagine what that would mean getting up every morning, knowing that somehow the world is going to be a better place because you're in it. That's an amazing feeling. And then to be on your deathbed and to know that you made a difference. throughout your life, in whatever way, you made a difference. The world really is a better place because you were in it. Now that is a life well lived.